Hey guys, how's it going? This is Jory Hope, and so in today's video guys, I'm finally going to be showing you what's on my iPod Touch 5th generation jailbreak slash applications version. So as you can see right here, I do have a theme installed and I am going to be getting into this theme in depth in a future video. However, this video is just dedicated to the tweaks and applications that I have installed on my iPod Touch 5th generation. So let's just go ahead and get straight into this video. So on my home screen right here, I just have pretty much everything arranged as normal. And first of all, let's go ahead and show you the jailbreak applications that I firstly have. So first of all, I have Activator, which is a pretty famous jailbreak tweak. It has been since the beginning of jailbreak, and pretty much this allows you to do actions via gestures. So for instance, let's say your home button is broken or your lock screen is broken, you can go ahead and go into anywhere and you can do something like let's go ahead and take a look right here, something like double tap the status bar and you can make that lock your device. So I'm just gonna quickly show you that. So if I go back and exit out of here, and as you can see right there, it locks my device without using my lock button. So that is Activator guys, it is completely free from the Cydia store. And after that I do have Barrel, which pretty much allows me to have nice animations on my device when I scroll between pages. So you can go ahead and view it right here. As you can see, when I slide to my next page, it's kind of like a curl animation, and it also works in the folders if you have multiple pages. So as you can see, it's a really nice tweak to have, and you also get a ton of variety of animations to choose from. You can go ahead and change it to icon collection. As you can see right there, that looks really nice as well. And you can also choose a random mode. So pretty much it does a different animation each time you switch pages, as you can see right there, and that is really nice as well. So that is Barrel guys, a really, really nice tweak, which in my opinion is completely worth the $3 it is for. After that we get Wi-Fi to Me, which is a free jailbreak application, and pretty much this allows you to get the password of certain Wi-Fi networks that are supported. So as you can see, when you go ahead and go into here, you get compatible networks and not compatible, and pretty much if you tap on a network, it'll give you the password. And so that is Wi-Fi to Me. So this is really, really handy when you're on the street and you need to connect to a Wi-Fi. You can go ahead and just use that application to crack in into a Wi-Fi network. And after that we have IntelliScreen X, which is a add-on to your notification center, which pretty much allows you to have your mail in your notification center. And as you can see here, you get dots, and that's courtesy of IntelliScreen X. And so also you get your Facebook feed, your Twitter feed, and Google News right here. And you can go ahead and modify settings from the settings application or from the icon that you get. So if you go into that, it'll actually redirect to your settings application. And here you can go ahead and change some settings so that you can have the tweak to your liking. So that is IntelliScreen X, a really nice application which actually does cost $10. However, in my opinion, it is completely worth it. And after that, we have VShare, which I only used to download WhatsApp. Since this is an iPod Touch, I could not purchase it from the Apple Store. As you can see here, I do have WhatsApp. And also, sometimes I do use it when I want to test an application before I actually purchase it from the Apple Store. So let's say I do I download a paid application and I test it out and I do not like it, and that way I did not waste my money on it. And so after that I have Winterboard, which is pretty self-explanatory. It works for themes. The current theme that I have is Carla for iOS, and I also have the icon theme, but I'm going to get into themes in a future video. So that's it for my application guys. Now let's go ahead and go into my settings add-ons right here. So if we go into the jailbreak panel, as you can see again, I have Activator, then I have Animate Battery, which when you connect your device and on the lock screen, it'll pretty much just show an animated battery while it's charging. After that I get Absent, which gives you a percentage of how much the application has been downloaded. After that I get an icon options, which pretty much gives you 2x2 layout fold for your folders. After that I get Barrel, then I get Clock Height, which works really nice with the Carla for iOS theme, because if I would not have that, I would have the clock overlapping right here, which does not look that nice. And after that I get Color Knob, which I cannot currently use because of the theme. However, it allows you to change the color of your knob. And a few more things. After that I have Diet Bulletin, which pretty much shows the banner the same size as your status bar. After that, I get Flag Paint, which pretty much allows you to customize your banners, the colors, and the sort of like that stuff. After that, I get Folder Enhancer, which allows you to enhance your folders, as I'm gonna demonstrate right here if I can eventually exit out of here. And as you can see right there, the folders look much bigger and better than the default iOS folders. And after that, I do have Intel Screen X, which I already showed you. After that, I have Kill Background, which pretty much places this nice little icon. If I tap on that, it'll kill all of the applications, as you can see right there, so that you not have to be constantly killing one by one the applications. And after that, I have NC Colors, which is a jailbreak tool for the notification center. As you can see right here, my notification center is kind of blurred. And so that looks really, really nice. And so that is courtesy of NC Colors. And after that, I do have NC RAM, which is an add-on for your notification center, and pretty much it tells you the available RAM on your device. And after that, we get NC Settings, which is an alternative to SB Settings, which I actually prefer, because for once it's on your notification center and the UI is really, really nice. So this works if you want to disable Wi-Fi or lock your rotation or respring your device, and so pretty much it has the same functions of SB Settings. And after that, I have Password Pilot, which pretty much works so that you do not have to type your password inside of the Apple Store when you want to download an application every single time. And there I get Safari Download Manager, which allows me to download files from Safari, such as videos, photos, and pretty much PDF files, and pretty much anything you desire. After that, I get Screen Extender, which allows me to extend the applications that are not compatible with the 5-inch screen of the iPad Touch 5th generation and iPhone 5. And so in this case, I'm going to be demonstrating it with Paper Toss 2. As you can see right here, I get these two ugly black bars, which do not look any good. And so if I go into Settings and I go into Screen Extender, and I go ahead and select Paper Toss, or if I go ahead and find it right here, so Paper Toss, where are you? And let's just go ahead and search for it, and Paper Toss, oh, here it is. And so if I select that and exit out, and so one thing that I will mention is that it does not work sometimes, so sometimes you have to do it multiple times. So if I launch it, as you can see right there, it did not work. So what we need to do is we need to kill it from the multitasking tray and settings as well, then go back into settings. And after that, we have to scroll again until we see Screen Extender. And so I would recommend that you just go ahead and try to disable it, just like that. And then you can go ahead and deselect the application and select it again, just like that. Just do that a couple times, then exit out and try to launch the application again. And as you can see, now the application is in full screen mode. So that works really, really nice. And there is actually a paid version called Full Force for phone or something like that, which costs 99 cents, which I'll do a review later on. And after that, I just get Winterboard and Zephyr. And so the Zephyr is an application that I can go ahead and use just to exit out of the application just like that, or to switch to a different application with two fingers. You can go ahead and change the settings of that. You can see it's essential multitasking gestures for your device, and you can open up the multitasking tray just like that. And so that is really nice. But so yeah, that's pretty much it for this video, guys. Those are all of the jewelry tricks and applications that I have on my device. So yeah, guys, please hit up that like button to see more videos, guys. And I hope you have a nice day, and I'll catch you all later.